Frequent floods have become a big problem nowadays, as have increasing sea levels. The Dutch have long built large dikes and storm surge barriers to protect their country. And yet today, climate change renders big parts of the Netherlands prone to flood risks.
It was only 1 year ago that we had the big flood disaster in the south of the Netherlands, in the region with Germany and Belgium. Even quite some, a number of people died. If you would ask them a couple of years ago, they simply didn't believe that it could happen.
One of the Dutch cities most affected by flood events is Rotterdam. Though the city is protected by a network of dikes and barriers, this does not hold for the areas outside the flood defense system. The residents on the unbanked island of Noordereiland regularly experience flooding.
The police was calling everyone have to wake up, pick up your car and move it aside from the water, because the cars are standing with the tires in the water.
What we see is that the average annual rainfall is about the same, but that it falls in a shorter amount of time, especially in summertime. We have those huge thunderstorms with a lot of rainfall in June and July on one day or in a few hours. And they are a huge threat for the city, not the continuous moderate rainfall. This is okay because our sewage system has a capacity of 20 millimeters an hour. So everything above is a problem. And those rainfall intensities we experience now, the last few years, are higher than that.
Due to this situation, the municipality is accelerating climate adaptation projects in the public and private space. One of these projects that have emerged in recent years are these floating houses. They can rise and sink depending on how much water is in the area at any given time. The same concepts are being applied to commercial spaces, like the floating office Rotterdam, which is the largest of its kind in the world, designed to even be moved to another location in extreme weather conditions.
In Rotterdam, space is really scarce. And in the next few years, we have to add 50,000 homes to our city before 2040. So it's only densifying and densifying. So you really have to make use of the scarce space that's there in order to make it climate proof. And already 4 years ago, we said, water management is not only about sewage pipes and pumping stations, it is urban planning. So you really have to integrate in everything you do.
The problem today for the policymakers is that they're actively involved in such planning, but each department works with its own data set. What is missing is an all-encompassing tool that helps them design the city together. This exact solution is already being assembled in the city of Utrecht by technology developers Nellen and Schuurmans, as part of the European research project IMPETUS. They are developing a decision support system which will be specifically focused on spatial planning in flood risk regions.
It will basically just be like a website that you can go to, especially tailored to the municipality, of course. And it will give you different types of flooding information for specific locations that you choose.
The IMPETUS tool will identify different types of flood risks in case of dike breach for specific locations and provide recommendations for corrective measures. One outcome could be, for example, the construction of a three-story house to ensure safety in case of flooding. Another could be the construction of floating houses in a defined area.
It's not that long ago, maybe the last 10 years, that spatial planners, urban planners, landscape engineers, take into account these climate risks in designing the new cities. You really have to know where the water is coming from, where the water will stay, how long will it stay, where do we leave the water after the storm event, etc. So the technology becomes part of the designing process.
One such example is the very first water square of Rotterdam, where a real-life situation is modeled in 3D as a complete digital twin. And within this 3D virtual world, the flow of water can be monitored in an accurate way. This is one of the important concepts behind the development of the IMPETUS tool for spatial planning. The municipality took the process further to make the public space dual purpose as both a water reservoir and skate park. Now, the heavy rainfall is no longer a threat to the surroundings. But in the Netherlands, the possibility of coastal flooding cannot be completely eliminated, and flooding in the low-lying coastal cities can cause big losses to their offices, hospitals, industries, and crucial infrastructure. This is why the IMPETUS team chose Rotterdam and the nearby province of Zeeland to develop their flood risk tool for spatial planning.
If you have a flood event, that is not very likely to occur, but if it will occur, the consequences will be very big, then the risk can still be quite high, actually.
Since the start of this project in 2021, the municipalities have been actively involved in the design of the development process of the IMPETUS tool. It is expected to be completed by 2025. The tool will help the policymakers visualize flood risks via simulation models and suggest accurate spatial planning solutions for their citizens.
Actually, only recently, the World Meteorological Office stated that by 2030, everybody in worldwide should have access to flood risk information and climate risk information. If we are able, within this framework and within this collaboration, to demonstrate the use and the capabilities of the technology, our ambition is definitely to apply it worldwide.